story, and it's a funny story, and it's funny now, and it probably wasn't quite that funny at the time. But that wasn't the worst of it. That was 2 years into it, and my daughter was on a better place then. She had been through therapy, she had been through work. 2 years before that, we were dealing with violence, anger, anxiety, nights of clawing, scratching, kicking, screaming, destroying things. The hurricane bathroom, I used to call it. And she would spend 2 to 4 hours washing hands, detail by detail by detail. And if that got disrupted for any reason, so it was my journey through hell. And I don't say that mildly because it was true. It was a household full of chaos. You couldn't cut that tension in there with a chainsaw. That's how bad it was. The tension between my wife and I got worse because of the fact that, you know, I thought this would be the best way to cure it. No, this is the best way to cure it. And of course, there was no absolute cure to it. The stress, the whole family gets, you know, the whole family is involved. It's not just the person with the disorder, and that's any disorder, it's not just OCD. The whole family gets it. In fact, I'm starting a site called Family OCD, where it's talking about that. I have to look up some. Oh, life closing in. Oh my God. You just don't go anywhere, you don't do anything. Because what happened after that Mouse and House incident, things were going so well with her. But then all of a sudden, she got triggered, one of her worst triggers in the world that threw her backwards. She ended up on the couch for over 8 months, not able to go anywhere, do anything, not able to touch anything or touch anyone or anyone touching her. Now, a lot of you are parents here. You can get a feel of what that would be like, not to be able to comfort your child when they're going, I want to commit suicide because I don't want to do this anymore, Dad. I hate this. And you can't go, it's okay. Come here, it's okay. You can't touch it, you know. That was my life for over 2 years. It was extremely stressful. The hopelessness factor. When you'd see a daughter come at you that's a zombie, a violent zombie on top of it, and you don't see the glitter in her eyes anymore. That's when hopelessness hits, and hits like a rock. And that's what it did for me. Those times when you just didn't know if she was going to come back. And then the final is the heart attack. A year and a half into it, I had a massive heart attack. And that's why I'm here and where I'm at now and why I'm doing the things I'm doing. Because it changed my life. Not all that I want. But by happenstance and what happened. So it was a bit of a rough time. Now, I'm happy to say she's 14 years old and she's doing really well. She's living a fairly normal life. OCD lives a lot of scars, still has trigger points, but she manages those trigger points. She doesn't blow up, she doesn't destroy the bathroom, flood it out, or any of that stuff anymore. She doesn't have to wash her hands for 4 hours, or take showers for 4 hours. She's, I say normal. Teens, let me throw that in there. A little bit of princess going on, you know. It's still some OCD. We still got some blends to work with, but she's doing good. But these are the things I work with when I do them, when I work with her. You know, the ERP. Exposure response prevention is the EFT, which is what we're going to do today, where I'm going to emphasize today. The naturopathic remedies we worked with. The movement therapy. I use Brain Gym for myself, for my clients, but it's movement therapy, doing body movements to be able to change what's going on up here, too. I use the Alpha Stem, which is a device, a wonderful device. Fairly simple device you clip on the ears, not like the TENS unit. Very different, don't feel pain, and it changes everything. I've seen miracles happen with it, and my daughter's one of them. Traditional medicine, of course, we still...